This is Stories of Injustice, Leipzig. In 1847, the first Jewish community was established in Leipzig. It continued to grow as the city attracted residents due to its central trading location. In 1935, the community gained an astonishing 11,000 members. At this time, Leipzig was not only the biggest Jewish community in Saxony and sixth largest in the whole of Germany, but also a relatively safe harbour for its Jewish community. Despite this, Jews were not allowed to open shops on main streets and had to pay protection money and carry a character document issued by authorities. The situation began to decline during the following decade. With the passing of the Enabling Act in March 1933, Hitler proclaims the Nazi Party the only permitted political system in Germany. Leipzig is on the peak of nationalism, with over 90% supporting the NSDAP. This city no longer welcomes diversity, replacing it instead with Aryan ideology, racism, and hate. On April 1, 1933, the NSDAP encouraged the population to boycott all Jewish shops. Just 6 days later, the Law of Restoration and Professional Civil Service was passed, and Jewish workers were purged from the civil service. Teachers were fired from schools, doctors and lawyers lost all their clients and permissions to operate, and books written by Jews were burned. Matters only got worse as the rights were taken from Jewish families in all spheres of life. After 1937, children were being kicked from schools, while the German children studied anti-Semitic texts.
They considered it an act of arrogance and haughtiness. How dared these lowly Jewish creatures so proudly display this cap in the presence of men of the superior master race? Did they not recognize their inferiority and lowly status in German society? On one occasion, we were confronted by Nazi Jews who lambasted and thrashed us because of our arrogance manifested by the cap. Some suggested that we wear white caps circled with red band to symbolize the Jewish blood they intended to spill. Bloody noses and swollen lips were the end result. It is noteworthy that two German police officers nearby were able to observe the entire scene and made absolutely no effort to intervene and halt the proceedings. So much for justice and equality in Germany, my father sadly remarked when I informed him of our encounter.
Men and women were discriminated at their workplace. Families were forbidden from entering synagogues or attending public meetings. Through the years 1933 to 1938, the Jews were abused and their human rights were violated. The climax began in 1938. On the night of November the 9th to the 10th, the Jews were directly attacked by the NSDAP party, the army, and even the regular citizens. 553 Jewish men were arrested. Community centres were destroyed, in addition to the vital synagogue, built in 1855. The beautiful building in Moorish revival architecture ceased to exist in the ever-growing flames of Nazi hatred. After the pogroms against Jews, 10,800 registered pupils remained in Leipzig. Approximately 5,000 Jews were expelled from Leipzig in December 1938 and sent to the Polish border. Although in the next years a mass migration occurred, many were still found in Jewish houses across the city. The first deportation took place from Leipzig Hauptbahnhof on January the 21st, 1942. This deportation transported Jews to concentration camps all over Europe and continued throughout the war. It is uncertain to which camps the Jews were sent to, but one fact is well known. From over 4,900 Jews in 1941, only 15 were left in 1945. More than half were sent to Riga, then to the Belzec death camp, or to the Theresienstadt on this train, from this platform. Some sources say that the final convoy of 169 Jews left Auschwitz in February 1945. Others state that 220 Jews were sent to Theresienstadt on February the 15th of the same year. Only 200 Jews were ever to return back to Leipzig.
Wie viele Juden wurden hier damals zur Arbeit gezwungen?
Also es ist eine Zahl von mindestens 1260 jüdischer Frauen und Kinder, die hier direkt in Leipzig bei der HASAG zur Zwangsarbeit eingesetzt wurden.
Sind noch viele offizielle Dokumente vorhanden oder wurden die nach dem Krieg zerstört?
Es wurden tatsächlich viele Dokumente zerstört. Allerdings im Falle dieses Außenlagers von Buchenwald haben wir verschiedene Unterlagen wie alle Namenstransportlisten, also die und auch einzelne Dokumente, die Aufschluss über die Nationalitäten und Altersstufen der Häftlinge geben.
Today, 140 empty chairs stand on the site of the Great Synagogue. They serve as a constant reminder, a tribute to the memories and crime of sins committed by the NSDAP. Only the Brody Synagogue remains in Leipzig, hidden in the depths of a residential building in Keilstraße. Not much is left of the once such a significant part of history in Leipzig, but the stories of those men, women and children against whom all the violent acts were committed will never be forgotten. All their stories will be told on from generation to generation as an immortal reminder to all.